I did that for like the start thing, so when I edit it, I can line it with footage. Anyway, welcome to the first episode of the Bedroom Podcast. My name is Gabe.
My name is Juan.
He's my guest. And basically, this is going to be a podcast where I just talk to my friends or just people I know and all that kind of stuff and talk about whatever. And yeah. But how are you?
I'm chilling.
You're chilling.
I'm chilling.
You're chilling. I just graduated and
hell yeah.
It was boring.
Mad boring.
It was very
hard to be outside.
Huh?
You had to be outside.
Yeah. And it was hot as shit, bro.
Bro.
And I was late too. I was like an hour late.
Damn, an hour?
Yeah.
How the fuck are you an hour late, bro?
Did they even let you in? Cause I had to go pick up Maddie. Maddie's my girlfriend, by the way. I had to go pick up Maddie and bring her to my house because my parents are bringing her. So I was already like 15, 30 minutes late. I left at the time I was supposed to be there, basically. And then I got there, and I was the opposite side of the graduation. Anyway, I walked over there, had my phone, and they're like, you got to put your phone back in your car. And I was like, what?
They said that shit?
Yes.
They couldn't hold it for you?
No. See, that's what I thought they were going to do, like take up all our phones. But like,
that's so fucking stupid. Yeah. Bro.
Thinking about it, though, I was like, that'd be kind of dumb if they did. Anyway, I walked all the way back. Realized I still had my AirPods, had to walk halfway back, then all the way back. I got in, bro, and everyone was just sitting there staring at me, like all the people in my class, and they're just like,
Like
everyone, dude. Man. I was the last one. I was the last one. I'm not joking. Anyway, I fell asleep at my graduation. It was mad boring. I'll put a picture up for the people who are watching. But yeah, what have you been up to?
Nothing much. I'm still doing trade.
How is trade?
It's way better than fucking high school, I'll tell you that much, bro. And college, in my opinion, because it's hands-on. So that's chilling because, you know, it's like two ways of learning. And you actually get to apply what you learn. So I like that.
When you start, like, getting a job, you said a year? Is when you
not
get,
even.
Like,
because once I, like, before I even graduate, I can get a job.
Oh, okay.
So, like, they helped me get interviews and shit.
When you graduate?
I think in about 4 months, I'll be getting ready to graduate. Because, like, there's two professors. So, when you start off... So, like, they get students on in, like, every 2 months.
Oh, okay.
Right? So, it's, like, wave of students that I sign. But, like, I think how it works is the first section, you start off with, like, one teacher. And you learn, like, you know, like, the majority of the class. When, like, once you get ready for graduation...
Yeah.
You switch over to this other teacher, and then he has, like, more experience. So, like, they give us job interviews and all that shit.
Uh-huh. So, okay. Yeah. But you like it.
Hell yeah.
That's good.
I like it a lot. Yeah. And it's a lot. It's flexible, too. So, I like that shit.
That's what's up. What time are you usually going in? What, like, 5, 6?
Dude, I got to wake up at, like, because it's 30-minute drive from where I live. And class starts at 7:30. But I got to wake up, like, get dressed, all that shit. And, like.
And what time do you get out?
And I get out, like, it depends because the teacher's, like, it's flexible, you know. But, like, set time is, like, 2.
Dang. All right, that's not that bad, though.
It's not bad.
If you think about it, that's really not that bad, to be honest. Hey, but I don't know. A lot of people, I think, are starting to, like, do that kind of stuff.
Trade and shit, yeah. It's because, bro, like, the school system doesn't change, bro.
Yeah, fuck the school system. I didn't learn anything in high school, dude. Okay, well, I didn't learn... Okay, I learned, like, 20%. Relevant stuff, you know what I'm saying? For the most part, it wasn't that relevant. Like, and this year I barely did anything. I learned how to sleep in my bed.
How to sleep in your bed?
Yeah, for my first 3 periods.
Fucking nap streak.
Yeah. Talk more in your mic.
Like right here.
Yeah, that's good. Bet. Or maybe a little. I don't know. Oh, let's. I'm telling about the nap streak. Basically, my sophomore year in high school. Which was 2 years ago. It sounds like I'm talking about it like it was a long time ago. Anyway, no, it was my junior year. It was last year. Yeah, it was last year.
It wasn't even last year. It was like the year before that, too, though.
No, it wasn't. Wait,
bro,
was it?
Time does not fly that fast.
No, it was some of my sophomore year. But anyway, my junior year, I basically napped every single day, at least once a day, every single day for, I think I reached like 15, 16 weeks.
That's fucking crazy.
And I would... I would basically like post on my story. That's how I'd keep track of it. And yeah, it was like 15, 16 weeks. And I did it until like Corona hit and we weren't able to go to school anymore. That's really the only thing I was sad about, not being able to go back to school. so I couldn't finish my nap streak, you know. I was good at it too. It was like the third week
you
in
were fucking good at it.
Yeah, it was like third week in school. I was like, you know what? I've been sleeping a lot. I'm gonna just do it throughout the whole year. And it was easy because I was waking up at like 4 a.m. to go to the gym. I would take some.
I don't even know how you fucking.
I don't know either, bro. Because this year I tried waking up at 7 going to the gym and I couldn't do it.
Nah, bro.
But no, I'd take some pre-workout, I'd crash and just sleep. And some days I think it was like a couple days I slept through every single period except for football. So.
But okay, but do you actually get rested? I feel like you don't actually get rested.
No.
You feel like dreadful, bro.
Yes. I feel like shit. Yeah, like, like. Sometimes there were some times where I would like wake up and I'm like, oh, I feel good. But there were a lot of times I woke up and I was like, fuck, like I have to go, I need to go back to sleep. Like, cause I remember it just makes shit. It just made me like really drowsy, which sucked.
Yeah, I remember that shit. Yeah. It wasn't even drowsy. It was like, it's like you got drugged and like you're trying to fight the like, the, like the high, bro. That shit is so trash.
Yeah, dude. That's, it was good. It's a good story, I guess. Mm. What's today? June 2nd.
June 2nd, bro.
They were
June 2nd.
Wait, they were
bro.
Supposed to release the stuff on aliens yesterday, right?
Oh shit! Yo,
I wonder.
Wait, look that shit up.
All right, one sec.
Yeah, but they're apparently so.
Explain, yeah.
Cause I don't know if. I mean, it's been pretty big on fucking internet, yeah. And shit. But apparently, like June 1st, they released like all the official like alien documentations and all that shit, like the government. And like the army bases and whatnot, mm-hmm. like all the footage and shit, it's like officially all released. Like, but that's pretty fucking interesting.
So I don't think they released it yet.
I mean, yo, look,
so
that happens, bro.
Obama said though. Obama came out. He said something. He said like aliens are real.
Aliens are real.
I don't know. I talked like real. Obama, but like he said something like that. I think. I don't think they released it yet. Did they say it was June 1st? Like
they said
sure?
It was June 1st, but it's one of the... Bro, they always be saying shit like that, though, and it never happens.
Mm.
Regardless, they're real. Nah.
I won't say they're not, because I can't say
There's
anything.
No way,
I can't
bro.
Say anything's not real if I haven't seen it with my own eyes.
But why do you say that?
Well, just because. I mean, that's just...
You have to see an alien for you to believe it. That's what you're saying.
No. But I'm saying I need to see one to solidify the fact that it's real in my head. But I'm not, I can't even say they're not real. I can't say aliens aren't real if I haven't seen an alien. Or like there's no factual proof out there that they aren't real. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I get you. I believe in them. And why I believe in them is because it's like.
I don't doubt that there's aliens.
Yo, you know how fucking big the universe is, bro?
Yeah, like, come on now. It's pretty big.
Like, based off of science of what we know, you know, like, there's, like, multiple galaxies.
Yeah.
There's, like, galaxies, like, within galaxies or some shit like that.
And we're just, like, a little speck in the whole entire universe. That is weird, dude. Sometimes I'll just be, like, laying in my bed. And I'll think about that. It scares the shit out of me. I'm not gonna lie. I'll be in my bed. Oh my god.
Yo, that's fucking funny because that's really fucking weird. Because when I was a little kid, I used to do the same fucking
dude,
shit,
bro. Just because, like, it's still hard. It's hard to grasp the like reality of like the whole world. If that makes sense.
Yeah,
like,
I get that.
Just how big it is and how small we are, and just like thinking how like everyone is like. Everyone is living their own separate lives, like, in the world. So, like, you know, I look at you. You're living your own separate life, kind of how I am. Not just in the sense that you are you to you.
I get that.
Does that make sense?
Not fucking really, but.
I mean, okay, no. Okay. Yo. So you think about, like, in a first-person video game, you're playing their story or something, or, like, you are them. You know what I'm saying? All right, never mind. I'm going to stop explaining this. I hope someone gets...
I mean, I kind of get what you're saying, but, like, it's kind of crazy because, like...
People are
like,
basically...
Think about it. There's how many people in the world, like... You meet strangers like, every fucking day.
There's, like, 8 billion or something like that.
Yeah. Like, you meet strangers every fucking day, and if you think about it, that stranger has a life of their own. Yeah. Like, has...
Okay, see, that's
a
what
complete
I'm,
that, different fucking, like, vision of the world.
That,
like,
that's what I mean. That's more of what I mean.
Yeah.
That, like, they have their own stories, their own history, all that kind
of
shit.
Everything. Like, even their own, like, perception of the fucking world.
Yeah.
It's fucking
that is
crazy.
But, I mean, at the end of the day, we are just all the same.
Kinda.
Well, I mean, we're all
I like essence wise, like matter wise, yeah, I believe that shit.
Yeah.
But like, I don't know, bro. We're like, humans are just fucking so much more advanced than any other fucking creature on this planet. Huh?
Are we? Well, okay.
I think so.
We've never been in the bottom of the ocean, but we're just advanced to ourselves, though. Okay, think about it like this. Think about it. We can't fucking breathe underwater for an hour like fish can.
No, we can't.
We can't. Well, they have
like, we're still humans. I mean, like, we're fucking animals. Like,
yeah, but who are we to say that we're at the... We're the most advanced just because we built stuff like this. Hey, beavers build dams and shit like that. And it could be the same thing as us building cities and stuff like that as to them building dams.
Yeah, but it's kind of fucking weird because, like, like we never, like, we're so, like, in advance is in the sense we're, like, we're not primal no more. Like, beavers build dams because they need to do that.
They've been doing that, bro.
Because they need to do that. Yeah, but exactly. That proves my point, though. They've been fucking doing that. They don't do anything else than build dams.
Yeah, they do.
No, they fucking don't.
They swim around.
Right, but like they build a dam, so like they never go further than that. Like they can't build a dam out of like metal and shit.
Do beavers build dams, right?
Yeah, beavers build dams. Like, not like... actual fucking dams.
Okay, I just didn't know if I was tripping. Like,
nah, beavers build dams. Okay, I think you're thinking about fucking platypus.
What do they do?
I don't fucking know.
Swim. Phineas and Ferb, bro.
Fuck Phineas and Ferb.
Why? I loved Phineas and Ferb, bro.
I mean, me too. But there's better.
Like what?
Cartoon Network, bro. What the fuck is that noise? Who's doing that shit? Is that your dad building the fucking?
Oh my god, my dad's mowing the lawn, bro.
Why the fuck is he mowing the lawn, bro? It's 7:20 p.m. He's gotta cut the grass.
He's cutting the grass. He's grinding. He's listening to this right now, bro. Watch what you say next. I'm kidding. Nah, he probably is. I don't know. He usually cuts it after he comes back from work because Jeremy doesn't. Basically, he would like pay us like $10 to mow the lawn or whatever.
$10.
And we all have a job now.
My dad would just whoop me, bro.
Yeah, that used to happen.
Huh?
He used to like tie us up to the lawnmower.
For real?
And just make us.
Are you serious?
Yes.
I mean, that's a good
fucking I'm literally way. Kidding.
You know, my
why would I say that?
My great grandpa, he used to just tie his children up on a tree and just beat them like a pinata. I know that's kind of crazy.
Oh, but you're serious?
Oh, yeah, I'm fucking serious. Yeah, that's crazy.
Not a bad idea, though. It's like kind of festive.
Yeah,
it's
but that also was like 100 years ago, so that's kind of fucking illegal now. And it was in a different country, so.
Illegal if they catch you.
True.
It was his kids.
True, but I mean.
Yeah, okay.
I mean, here it's illegal, but it's like fucking Venezuela, so.
Yeah, I guess. But yeah, he usually mows the lawn after work. Because that's usually.
That's dedication, bro.
Yeah, he's a grinder. He grinds. Shout out to my dad. Anyway, what's better than Phineas and Ferb? I'm not saying there's nothing out there, but I'm curious. To what you
look,
think.
Man, I could name. Okay, so I'm gonna be real.
Okay,
I wasn't real. A TV kid.
Okay,
I wasn't. I just wasn't a TV kid. I was a like go outside and play with mud type kid, okay. Like or Legos or some shit like that. You know.
I love.
But Legos. When I did watch TV, I liked like Cartoon Network. Like I liked to watch like Courage the Cowardly Dog.
That show sucks.
It doesn't that suck though, sucks. Bro. It that doesn't suck though because yeah, I remember no because
you're
I remember
the type of kid to like Chowder, huh?
No, not Chowder. I liked fucking dude. There was this one show and I Regular Show. And Adventure Time.
Everyone loves Regular Show.
I mean, yeah, because
that's a good ass show.
Because Chowder's like one of those like fills the channel and then it gets fucking removed.
Dude, but no. But people actually loved Chowder. Like that was like a fan favorite show.
I mean, because...
I don't know why, but it was weird. It was weird. That show made me uncomfortable.
It was a weird era in general.
It had a crusty feeling to it. You know what I'm saying?
Said crusty feeling. It I just, get that,
it
though.
It felt crusty.
I think it was Captain Flapjack.
I
think that one was more fucking crusty than
that's
Chowder.
That's actually, dude. Actually, that's the one I was thinking about when I said crusty. I wasn't thinking of Chowder yet.
Yeah.
I just didn't know the name of that. That one is weird. Yeah, it's just like... It's like weird. Smelly...
like it's like fucking smelly, bro.
I get
agree,
smelly
though.
Butthole vibes from that one, dude. Yeah. I don't know. I never liked that show. I watched a bunch of Regular Show. A lot of regular show. And then what else did I watch?
There was,
I don't remember.
There was a, I think there was a celebrity that was on regular show.
Celebrities?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, I'm sure.
I forgot who it was, though.
Dude, because regular show was, like, very popular.
I don't even think I, like, watched, like, every episode type shit, though.
I'm sure I did.
Again, I wasn't a TV kid.
I'm sure I did, bro. They had to be on acid making that show.
I mean, yeah,
I promise they had to, bro, because, like,
dude, not even they'd really be regular show,
they'd be
though.
Chilling, yelling at that gumball dude. What's his name? Banks? No.
Nah.
Mr. Anyway, they'd be yelling at him, and the next second, they're, like, in a different universe with some, like, grown-up babies or some shit. Like, it was weird. I don't know.
That was a crazy
It was a cool show, though. I don't...
Skips, bro?
Skips. Like, Skips. He was...
Like, the big-ass you know monkey and Yeah, his girlfriend and shit. Yeah. Like, what the fuck?
Oh, my God, dude. I remember I found out about that. I was like, dang.
Yeah, I remember Full circle. Shit. No, but I say...
My mom...
Yeah. No, that was a fat dude, bro.
Yeah, the green dude. Muscle man, bro.
Muscle man. Yo, nah, I remember, I say Courage, though, because, dude, like, it's the one that stands out the most. Like, you can't even lie. You're a kid, and you watch that shit, and you're like, what the fuck is going on?
I never
like,
even.
You can't help but to watch that shit.
No, I, oh, wait, you liked it.
Like, it's not that I liked it. It's just I remember watching it, and I would be, like, intrigued. Not that I liked it, but, like, I was intrigued. Like, I was like, what the fuck is this?
I never watched that show.
Dude, I went back and I watched it as, like, you know, like, older.
Uh-huh.
And I just, like, watched a few episodes.
And it was garbage.
It's not garbage. It's just, like,
weird.
A bunch of demonic shit.
Oh, I just, nah, dude. It looked too crusty, so I never watched it.
I mean, that's Cartoon Network, though.
Yeah. Bro, did you ever, I feel like you never watched Disney, did you? I feel like you'd think that shit was corny.
Corny as fuck,
dude. Bro. Hannah Montana. Ooh, that show fuck was good, no. Bro.
I mean, there was like Wizards of like Waverly Place.
Okay,
yeah. I could fuck with that. You feel me?
Yeah, that one was pretty good, dude. I remember Hannah Montana. They had the God damn it, dude. They had this movie. They had this movie that came out. I think it's called Last Song or whatever.
You and said it, what?
It's called The Last Song because basically, you know what Hannah Montana was? Basically, this girl. Who was like a pop star.
Yes, okay. I know what and Hannah Montana okay, I didn't is, know if bro. You knew. It's I fucking didn't know Miley you Cyrus, yeah. Bro.
It's Hannah Montana, bro.
Yeah, whatever.
Anyway, the last song is like her revealing that it's all like an act, and she basically it's just revealing that she wore a wig her whole entire career.
That was the last episode.
Yeah, and she took off her wig. I remember I was sitting there. I was probably like 10 or something. I got a little emotional. I was like, dang.
Are you fucking serious?
I swear to God,
nah, bro.
I swear. I swear, bro. I swear. She took off her wig and she started crying. She's like, guys, I'm not in Montana. And I was like,
I just thought it was corny the whole fucking time because I was like,
dude,
how do you
sure
just,
it is. Sure it is.
It's, how do you not know it's
her? A Disney show for kids, bro.
Okay, but speaking about Hannah Montana, let's talk about the little Hispanic dude.
Rico.
Yo, he aged into a fucking backwood, bro.
Dude, you know he's like he acts still now, bro.
Yo.
He was in this like really popular movie. My parents are watching it. I forgot what it's called.
Dude, that's fucking
it's about
crazy,
some like Colombian
bro.
Soldiers or some shit, bro.
Colombian.
Yeah, I swear to God. And he was actually really good.
I'm gonna be real, bro. I feel like Disney actually just corrupts children. Like it doesn't keep them innocent, bro, with that contract, bro. It corrupts them.
Like the actors?
You know what I heard? I was talking about this shit with my coworkers yet. Speaking about Hannah Montana, actually, matter of fact, so they were talking about that bitch JoJo Siwa.
Oh, dear.
You know, the one that doesn't change.
Yeah.
She's been the same for like years. But anyways, yeah. Point is, like, apparently, like, with Hannah Montana as well, like, they enter like a fucking lifelong contract.
Yeah.
And in order, like, the only way to get out of that is for them to do like crazy shit. And that's why, like, Hannah Montana, like, completely did a 180.
Dude, but her music is good now.
Yes.
Maddie listens to her all the time. She's actually really good. Like she has a good like rock.
Yeah,
like,
no, I agree with that. But think about it. When you know that you want to go into that direction, but you're bound to fucking Disney, like you have to go to the extreme in order to reach that middle. Because hey, like she needed to get out of the contract.
Dude, but I'm sure they were a bunch of teenagers. Like they're a bunch of so you're saying that people have to do some like off the wall shit. So
for
Disney's
them to drop
like, we don't want you.
Exactly. That's what they had to do. You. And so that's why JoJo Siwa, I heard that apparently she came out like lesbian.
But like,
no, she's actually a lesbian.
That's fine. But like, they were saying that she did that to get out of the thing. And I'm not.
Wait, she's on a Disney contract?
She's on a Disney contract.
Oh, and you think they did that to?
She's a Disney kid. Why do you think that she's has not changed? I swear, when I was a child, she was still like that.
Yeah. Okay. But some, I don't know, dude. Some people speculate that that literally just is her. I mean, and that's cool if that's just her. I don't know. I feel like it kind of is because, like, at first, she's kind of, I don't know.
Come on, no.
Dude, but think
you,
about.
You have, there's something wrong with her then, bro.
Nah.
She in love with the money, bro. Is she fucking still looking like that?
I don't know.
There's it's different like, ways to market your shit, bro. There's no way she chooses to stay.
You like never know. Okay, but, like, just think about it like this. There's, like, a lot of grown people that are, like, a kid at heart, and they do a lot of, like, kiddish things, I guess you want to say. And I kind of, I feel like that's kind of where she is. She, like, doesn't want to grow up, maybe.
I mean, she's only 16.
Dude, she's like 18.
She's like 17.
All right, bet. Let me look it
look
up.
At that. Look that shit up, bro.
How old is JoJo Siwa? Okay. Fuck Siri. JoJo Siwa.
Like, she's choosing to stay like that, bro. There's no way.
Yeah, obviously she is because she still is like that. JoJo Siwa is 18 years old.
Are you fucking serious?
Yes, her birthday actually just passed, May 19th.
She choosing to stay like she's dude, not out of the Disney contract, bro. Look up if she's out of the Disney contract.
Is JoJo Siwa out of the Disney contract? College what? Contract. JoJo Siwa signed the contract with Nickelodeon. During her time at Nickelodeon, she's been part of various TV shows, but now the contract is officially ended. So she doesn't have a contract with anyone.
Nah, bro.
Yes. Dude, just think. Okay, anyway. I don't know. It's JoJo Siwa, bro.
Fuck that.
Who cares? Hey, she's getting a bag. And
you're right.
She is. And honestly, bro, she can go for 2 more years, completely cut the act, still have at least like half of her fan base, still make a bag.
She doesn't even have a fucking fan base, though.
Are you sure? Are you sure? Are you sure? Those numbers in the M's next to her name on
because
social media
she's a
definitely
joke,
says opposite.
Bruh. She's a joke.
She's not, dude. Little kids look up to her. I'm so serious. Anyway, on to something else.
Yeah,
bro.
Fuck JoJo Siwa.
You're getting triggered about JoJo Siwa. I think you're salty about.
I'm not even salty. It's just like.
You sound very salty. You're salty that she's getting a bag.
That she's getting M's for some stupid shit. Yeah, you're right.
I don't think it's stupid. I would love to do what she's doing now. Dude, think about it like this. She just graduated high school. Right?
Yeah,
she doesn't need to go to college.
That's
all
fine.
She has to do is post videos of her screaming on social media and wear those clothes. She's making bags.
You know what? You're kind of fucking right.
I am.
She
right.
Literally could be a different person.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying.
Right, bro.
You never know. You're or that is literally right. Just her. You got to think.
There's all kind of people in this
setting
world.
Setting herself up for success right now.
I mean, I guess.
A big bag. A humongous bag. Humongo
she
bag.
She drew that shit out for like all my childhood, basically.
I never even like knew about her until like 3 years ago, maybe.
Nice.
But I do have her blocked on all social medias.
Why? How you gonna talk about me hating her? And
I,
you have
I never
blocked?
Said I hate her.
Why do you have her blocked?
I strongly dislike her.
Whatever.
I strongly dislike how loud she is.
I'm not going to say strongly dislike in a sentence, but
I wouldn't even say I strongly. I just dislike how loud she is. And one time she came up on my For You page. What's up, guys? Did you just see what I'm doing? And I was like, you know what? I'm going to block her. I'm going to block her. And that's what I did.
Feel that. Yep. Enough about JoJo Siwa, though.
Siwa.
JoJo Siwa, bitch.
Yeah. What are your plans for the next month, Juan?
For the next month. Yep. You know what? I like that you asked me that, bro. That me up type really? Shit. It's the homie right there. He always.
All
right,
now. Cool.
What you doing, bro?
We're going to hold hands.
Oh, this is going to be the.
All right, this is the thumbnail.
Yeah, this is the thumbnail.
Anyway.
This hand's kind of sweaty. But hand. All right, bro.
Skating.
Oh,
skating.
Dude, bro.
I saw For the people that don't know, there's a big company called Baker Boards. They're also like affiliate with like Death Wish boards. They're like the same brand almost, right?
I think I don't know.
They're like the same brand, different team, I guess.
I think that's what it was.
Yeah.
I know there's one. I know there's one. That did that. But
yeah. Anyway, it was like big brand. I was at a skate park today, and like 8 of them, maybe 10, pulled up, and they just started just shredding.
That's fucking crazy.
Bro. Yeah, it was very cool. But when did you first start skating?
Me?
Yeah.
So I first started skating, I think I was in junior year.
High school.
Or I wanted to skate in sophomore, but all I had was a penny board.
Oh, dude.
Yeah, I don't know how many people relate to this fucking story.
Oh, definitely a lot of people, bro.
But yeah, all I had was a penny board laying around. So I just started cruising with that, and I guess I just got control with that shit. And then I told my dad,
dude,
like,
did it stop recording? But go on.
I told my dad, all right, fuck.
You told me.
I told my dad, like, yo, like, I really want to fucking skate. Like, please get me a board. I don't know if it was my birthday or not. But yeah, you know, every like, you know, like beginner shit, like you go to fucking Zoomies, get like a half-ass setup for like the...
You got
to
complete.
Like the complete setup for like what? Like
$75?
Some shit like that, yeah. And I got a fucking ripping dick deck, bro.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Yeah. But
it's tough.
Yeah, it's fucking tough, bro. But that dick. Yeah. But that's when I like really started skating, because... First grade, I went through that, you know, phase with my sister because we had those neighbors.
And
they were crazy, bro. They were fucking good.
I remember you telling me about that.
Yeah, they were fucking good. But, like on my own type shit, yeah, it was around that time. But it's been on and off. I won't even lie. Like, I'm beginner shit. Like, on some beginner shit, bro. Like, you know that. But, because it's on and off. And, like,
but dude,
it's consistency.
You started doing really good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, dude, skating is just all about consistency, because like you start doing really good, and then like you stopped for a minute, then like you can barely ollie now.
Type shit.
I mean, you can ollie. I'm not trying to shit on you.
No, you don't shit on me. I mean, it's the fucking truth. It's what happens.
It's a competition, bro.
I mean,
went far, bro.
That's fucking facts.
We were neck and neck for a minute, though.
Neck and neck, bro.
Yeah. Now I'm trying to battle out with Jonah.
Jonah's pretty solid,
Jonah's good, but...
Pretty fucking solid.
Yeah, I don't know.
But yeah. I just got trained and shit, so it's like, momentum too. It's not even about excuses, because if I really wanted to, I'd go to the skate park.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, so it's not,
or
even,
not
that.
Even that. You can just skate like
anywhere
in front of your house, anywhere like that. Yeah, dude, because we used to, what is it called? We used to grind that rail and like the tennis court.
I mean,
I can
still hit the rail. I just can't ollie like high enough to go to the fucking park and hit the rail.
I think my camera stopped recording.
Let me go check that hole real quick. Intermission.
Dude, can you bring my water back too?
Your water?
Yeah. Anyway,
is it the big zoom?
Yeah, it's that blue one.
Movie recording has been stopped automatically.
All right, just
maximum recording time has been reached.
Yeah, just re-record. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, that's good right there. Yeah, there you go. Thank you to everyone who is listening and who has listened this far or watched this far. I'm gonna try and do these every week. I'm gonna have a different friend or person for, you know, the start of it, and then I'll definitely have like reoccurring guests and stuff like that. But I basically just kind of want to just talk to them, have a conversation. I don't know, maybe talk about a certain topic. Maybe if the people listening, probably like the five people,
maybe ten. I mean, you get
maybe
you,
five.
You have some followers. But yeah.
Some dead followers on TikTok. Anyway, no. If there's anything specific we should talk about or any tips or whatever, let me know. But this is what I'm going to do for now. And yeah, I think it's all. We've been trying to do this for a minute.
Bro.
So we recorded a first one. And originally I wanted the podcast to be like a deep topic one, something deeper. We started talking about the school system and stuff like that, which we could talk about briefly, but it was fucking 40 minutes of school system talk and stuff like that.
That shit, no one wants to listen to that.
I wouldn't even say no one wants to listen to it, but that's just not the direction I necessarily want to go for. I don't want people to be like, okay, I got to brace myself to listen just fucking political ass, like serious ass, you know, whatever. So
yeah, I feel that.
But yeah, so I changed it up. I decided, why don't we just do a conversation? That's easier anyway, because, you know, conversation. It's easy. It's nice to listen to.
Smoother too.
Mm-hmm. Definitely, because the last episode, I was like, "What's up, guys? It's Juan." Whatever. I was like, "All right, let's talk about the school system." Yeah. I was like, bro, I watched that part back, and I was like, "Oh fuck."
Yeah.
Damn. Mm. What'd you do today besides trade? You did trade, okay?
Yeah.
That's
pretty much fucking.
I respect that very much.
I mean, I got to sleep in. That's something. Because you know how I said they have like waves of students come in like every 2 months or whatever.
Yeah.
Like a new fucking wave came in, so I had to go in like late. Like it was like what time? Like class started at like 11:30.
Uh huh. Oh, okay. So, oh, that's not bad.
Yeah, I got to sleep in.
Well, you slept in until like 10:30.
Yeah.
Bet, that's good, bro.
Just about 10:30.
I got up and I went.
My bad.
No, you're good. Speaking of sleep, I just went on a trip to California.
Mm. Oh yeah, tell us about that shit.
San Francisco. I went to San Francisco with my girlfriend, Maddie. Anyway, we're there. It's a nice place, bro. It's beautiful. I definitely like it more than LA. Last Christmas.
Why do you say that though? Like. Cause I understand it's like you and your girl, you know, like one-on-one experience.
Okay, yeah. So I'm just,
but like
I'm
not talking, I mean, like the pros and cons, like scenery and.
So
all that
that's
shit.
What I'm talking about. I'm talking about like from experience wise, not. I'm talking about like, what's that word? Like setting wise, I guess, rather than, you know, experience wise. So like me and Maddie, it's just nicer, bro, and it's cleaner for sure. Like there's definitely still like a bunch of like homeless people and stuff or whatnot, but like it's not LA where, you know, there's just like a lot like nothing
tent cities,
nothing against
like
homeless
that.
People. I love homeless people.
Me too, bro.
They're
cool. Mad interesting. I want
they lie. Actually are, and some people got some good stories. But anyway, no, it's definitely it's way less trashier than LA, I guess. And I think it's just more laid back and chill, and the people there were really cool too. Like, L.A., I kind of got the vibe. It was, like, people were kind of like, I'm better than you kind of vibe.
Yeah.
And everyone was kind of, like, trying to do.
I mean, it's L.A., bro.
Yeah.
You know the hype.
And everyone was kind of like, I don't know how to explain, like, TikTok influencer-y.
Oh, yeah.
You know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah,
but,
yeah,
no, San Francisco was nice, bro. A lot of different people.
Mm-hmm.
It was very cool. We went to some kind of, like, I don't know, like, it was, like, a street. And it was, like, an Italian street, I guess, or something like that.
Yeah.
There's a bunch of Italian, like, eateries and stuff like that around. It was actually really
cool. That's pretty
cool.
Fucking sick.
They were nice, all kind of stuff. It was good.
You eat Italian food?
Yeah.
You sat down and ate Italian food. What'd you have?
I just had some noodles and some meatballs, but it was good.
Spaghetti and meatballs.
Spaghetti and meatballs.
Meatball parmesan.
Meatball parmesan. Yeah, I got parmesan on my shit, but the sauce is a little too watery. I like some thick sauce because it just like hugs your noodles. You know what
yeah.
I'm saying? And just slide right off. Anyway, so we did that.
You know, like eat it off the bottom.
Yeah,
and shit.
Yeah. But we visited Golden Gate Bridge. Dude, there were a bunch of bunkers, a bunch of like old military bunkers. Those were like actually really cool.
You want to go see military bunkers?
Yeah.
Like you got to pay for entry?
No.
Though?
They're just like there. You can just go.
What the fuck?
Yeah. I took a bunch of videos. You'll see it when I,
edits and all that.
Yeah. It was really, it was actually really cool. Anyway, drove to Utah. Utah was cool. It was cool. We stopped by this like salt dune.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there goes my daddy with a lawnmower. Anyway, we stopped by like the salt dune or something, where it's literally just like just salt. It's like just a plane. I don't know what it was called. It's like a salt plane or something like that. It was really cool. Drove back, or we stayed in Utah. We just kind of ate. Went to Park City, and that was Park City was cool. Anyway,
Park City.
Yeah, the drive back was. Rather
talk about this shit, bro.
Rather like it was okay.
It was I didn't even know like why you even fucking did that.
Okay,
shit.
Okay. Well, because we went because Maddie's parents stayed there, right? They like live there and they have the two cars. They have the camper, whatever, and then they have her mom's car. We drove her mom's car back. Yeah. Anyway, we were driving the first day to Utah was not bad at all. just a long drive. It was really pretty though, like a bunch of mountains and stuff, mm-hmm. which I don't see stuff like that all the time, so I was very appreciative of that.
Right.
Second day, same kind of thing. You know, we drove through Colorado, very, very pretty.
Are you serious?
Oh yeah, dude.
So it lives up to the hype and shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Colorado was very pretty. It felt nice outside, all that kind of stuff, until I started driving. Right. And I started driving, and I get to the top of the mountain. And that shit is scary, bro. I'm driving on the edge of the mountain. It's just like a two-way lane.
It's like a two-way lane type shit.
Yes.
Togi.
No guardrails, bro. No guardrails. So I'm just driving on the side of the mountain.
No guardrails.
No guardrails, bro. And Maddie's like kind of like shitting her pants in the passenger seat. Say, oh, slow down. Oh, no, don't move.
She's fucking
so
stupid,
I'm trying to
bro.
Like, I'm trying to drive or whatever. Anyway, that wasn't terrible. But then I get on top of another mountain and it's raining. It's raining and it's snowing. And so
it's like sleet type shit.
Well, it was icy, I guess I would say. There's a bunch of like snow patches on the side of the roads,
uh-huh.
and like some kind of seeping into the road. That sucked, dude. I hated that. Cause
how fast were you going? Let me ask. You were going like 5 miles an hour, and there's like cars behind you and shit like that.
I won't cap, bro. I was going like 15 on a turn. There, I'm serious. Cause like all of it's just a bunch of turns. You're just like turning through mountains and stuff. But it was really pretty. We got out and took a picture on, like, the side of one of the mountains. But it started raining. It was, like, terrible. We got caught behind this. What are those trucks that, like, all those crushed up cars? Or, like, we know what.
They're on top of that mountain, bro?
It was like a big truck. Like, a big pickup truck almost with a bunch of the cars. I don't know what it's called. But
I know what you're talking about. They just racked that two stories of, like, fucked up cars.
Yeah,
just so you could shit yourself even more on the fucking ride.
We were stuck behind them for about 20 minutes, and they were going actually 15 miles per hour. No joke. The whole time.
Yeah. I mean, I don't fucking blame them, bro.
Yeah, me neither. But, like, then they finally moved to the side. So, the thing is that. It was a 15-hour drive. 15 hours, which sucked.
So from where to where, though?
From Utah to Amarillo, Texas. Yeah. And so we get to New Mexico, and it is pouring down rain.
And y'all are still on mountains
and dark.
And
it's dark as shit. The one thing I said, I was like, I don't want to drive in the dark. And I did. And it was pitch black, bro. It was dark as hell. Raining. I hated that. And then we get to this part in New Mexico where, dude, I hated it. This was the worst part. So it's like 11 right now, 11 p.m. I'm tired as shit. I got like no sleep almost this whole trip too. I just got terrible sleep. I don't know why.
Y'all fucking dumb for that shit, bro.
But we made it. But it was this long road and it was just narrow. I could only see like 3 feet in front of me, even with my high beams on. It was terrible. But all that aside, it was a good trip.
I mean, it's an experience, bro.
Yeah, dude. That's what I'm saying. Like, that's pretty I would do it again, bro. I'll do it again. I'll drive back again. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't get to see stuff like that every day. Mm. We live in Texas. Damn, I just talked about that for a long time. But
I mean, it's all right.
Yeah, but we live in Texas. And there's really not much.
I get that.
There's not a lot of cool stuff, I would say.
I mean, you got to look for it. That's the thing.
Yeah.
You got to fucking look.
But, like, really, if you do look, like, what is there?
I mean, but then again, we've been living here all our lives and shit.
True, bro. Like, cause some people could come down here
and be like, "Oh my god, it's so like it's wide and shit like that." Like, no weird shit, but
so wide.
Yeah, like,
what does that mean,
bro? Cause you come here and like it's not crowded here, bro. Mm. Spacious, a better word.
No, that's true. Oh, that's another thing about San Francisco. Not as crowded.
It's not crowded.
It is, but not to that extent. At all.
But like, there's a fuck ton of people in there.
We didn't really run into traffic. We ran into traffic once.
I mean, I guess.
So, in LA, we always ran into traffic.
Because it's LA, bro.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
It's 24/7, bro.
I just liked it better. But it was cool.
I get that, though. It's pretty solid. How far are we into this?
I don't know. I think we're like, we could be like 30 minutes or so. Did it say how long that last recording was?
Nah, I just said it was too. It like reached the limit for.
I'm not sure how far we are.
We're like 45 in.
I definitely don't think we're at 45, bro.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, we are. We're like 40 in.
No, we're not, dude. Let's see when we started this thing, bro. Let's see, because I think I had texted Maddie.
It's pretty fucking solid, though. I like Maddie's mom's car, though.
Yeah,
the Challenger, that one's fucking cool.
I love that Challenger, bro. Yeah. Okay, I think we might. Yeah, dude, we're like, I think we might just be approaching 40 minutes.
Damn. I think we're doing a lot better than last recording. Sorry.
Yeah, my bad. I definitely think we are. Because last time it was just about the same thing.
Same shit.
Every time. But was there anything you were looking to talk about?
Let me see.
Any things that have happened? Do you invest in stocks?
Fuck no.
And like Bitcoin and shit?
I got already too much on my plate for that shit, dude.
Okay. Yeah, that's been a big thing. I don't really know stuff about it, but apparently people are getting like robbed out of these like crypto thingies. I don't
Fucking cryptocurrency.
Yeah, people.
I'm not up to date with that. So
me neither. I honestly don't really know shit about it. It's only because like I listen to this podcast and they talk about it all the time,
dude. Yeah,
it's Tiny Meat Gang. If you listen to Tiny Meat Gang, Tiny Meat Gang.
Tiny Meat Gang.
Yeah, they're the reason I want to start a podcast. To be honest.
For real.
Yeah.
Send me the link.
I bet they're like
link in the description. I'm not in charge of the channel, but
link in the description.
We shouted them out. We don't have a fucking choice. You feel me?
Link in the description.
Yo, but
yeah. Hit that like button.
Smash that like button. My bad. So yeah, bro.
RIP to anyone listening with headphones.
Yeah.
Got clapped.
What the fuck were we talking about?
I don't know.
Cryptocurrency. Yeah, I'm not up to date with that. Let me see.
I don't know anything about it. I do want to try and invest in stocks, though.
How do you feel? You're out of high school.
Okay.
It's a big turnover for most people, you know. Uh-huh. Come on, like. Not into detail, just like feeling-wise. Like, how do you feel? Because when I got out of high school, I was like, fucking finally, you know.
Yeah.
Like, I completely forgot about school.
That's how I feel, to be honest. I definitely feel, like, relieved because, dude, I think in the last 2 years, I really realized, like, how much I hate school.
Yeah.
And, like, how much it does not benefit me in a lot of ways. Mm-hmm. I don't want to say that school doesn't benefit you in any possible way, but for me personally and the things I want to do, it just didn't have that much use. And like all the quote unquote success that I made was all stuff I learned on my own. I learned that through YouTube. Like I learned how to do video stuff and all that kind of stuff. I learned it outside of school. I did it on my own and I found way more success in that than I did in fucking test.
Right.
And stuff like that. You know what I'm saying?
And you think a lot of it plays a part because it's like shit that you want to do?
Yeah, dude. Yeah. I definitely think it is. I think that like there are things that we should have to learn in school. You know what I'm saying? But
I mean, there's things like, that I think we should learn in school that we don't. You know, like basic survival needs exactly, and all that like, shit, but we don't.
I don't know. Like money, like dude, money management or money matters or whatever, same kind of deal. It's like an optional class.
But still, like I said before, it's a coach teaching that shit.
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
Like,
but
you
like,
know what goes down when
exactly
teach your fucking
so you
class.
Just don't do anything. But like, I mean, you come out of high school not knowing a lot of things, you know, and some people don't have the right parental guidance to actually learn those things. And like, I don't know, just like a lot of life things. But anyway, I know there's a lot that I learned out just on my own. And, you know, just I don't know, trying to learn on my own and trying to feed my own ambition, you know, when it came to film.
And skating too, bro. Because like you said, like we were neck and neck.
Yeah.
And you kept the fucking consistency up, bro.
Exactly. Skating.
That's something I can't fucking, that's something that I've been working on.
Consistency. And consistency is important with anything, bro.
Anything. And I agree with that shit.
Because once you really hop on it and you like get your flow going with anything, then you really keep going and like you can't really be stopped. Like,
It's growth. Yeah. It's consistent growth
exactly,
as well,
bro.
Yeah.
Like, I ran into a wall with like my film stuff and all that kind of stuff when I got to like college applications and stuff because it was stressful. Then I like, we left to LA and then I had to I had to pick up my grades for school and then we just left I just left to California again. Anyway, no, as I like I just haven't done anything. That's because I got out of my consistency. But I think once you get into it, I think that's with anything. Like if you have an ambition that you want to do or something you've always wanted to do, just work. Just work as hard as you can. I think once you really start like working and you see like results that you like, you just won't
want
to stop,
bro. Yeah,
it's just like with
I
working
think that's
out or something
big too. Yeah,
Yeah, it's results. Like, always see how far you've come.
Yeah, and the more consistency, the more results, and, like, the faster they come as well.
Yeah, dude, like, exactly. Because, yeah. Dude, I've been doing film for, I don't want to just keep, like, I've been doing it. But anyway, just giving an example. Like, I've been doing film for, like, dude, like, under a year. I made my first short film this school year right after Christmas break.
And you submitted them and everything. Yeah. And all that. Honestly, bro, I'm going to say, like, I think that's above average.
Thank you.
I'm
not even. I appreciate that. I appreciate that.
To under a year, you made what? Four short films? Five? You made four.
Four, I think.
Four, yeah. And damn, and you got them submitted and all that to like contests and all that shit. Mm. That's dedication.
Yeah, bro. Dude. But see, here's the thing. I wouldn't say it's above average or anything like that.
I mean, like,
it's just ambition.
I feel that.
Think about it like this. Anyone can do what I'm doing right now. Anyone can do it, like, mm-hmm. And there are so many people better than me at my age.
Yeah.
And why is that? That is because there's been way more time put into that, all that kind of stuff. Dude, like, I still watch all mine back, like, even my most recent one and all that kind of stuff. And I look back, I'm like, okay, there's still so many things I can do better.
Yeah.
About this, you know what I'm saying?
And I mean, it's also like standard equipment, bro. You in high school.
Yeah, no, that's like, very true. But even story-wise, you know, a story can be built with nothing, you know, just through your head.
I agree.
But no, I mean, I wouldn't say, no, I appreciate that. I would appreciate you saying I'm above average, but I think a lot of people just in general look at anyone else that is doing something and it's just like, I don't know, they're doing good at it, I guess, and they're like, oh, damn, like, they're crazy good, like, damn, how do they get there? And it's just like, you can get there, too.
Yeah.
It just requires some work, and I think that a lot of people, I don't know, they don't really achieve the stuff they want to do because they think this is, like, such a far-fetched thing. But, like,
I agree. Yeah.
It's corny, but really, at the end of the day, anything's possible.
Yeah.
Like, if you do want it bad enough and you put in the work for it, like...
And you also got to be realistic, bro.
Yeah, no, that's true.
Like,
as well.
If you fucking beat yourself about the end result,
yeah.
Just like,
yeah, dude,
you're
but,
not going to reach the end result.
Yeah. Because
you're going by it in a negative, like,
yeah. You know, exactly. Way. Like, the thing about, like, you want to learn from your end result. Even if it's shit, like, it doesn't matter. I think a lot of people are also scared about making something that's not good.
I agree.
You know, but you have to make stuff that's not good to make something good.
I agree. Because
how else are you going to learn? Like, you can't just. I don't know. You can't try to... You can't bust a tray flip.
I think it's more, you know? Of like learning to embrace the process of things. You know, I heard... I was watching this dude. Because, you know, I got stuck in one of these holes too.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
You know, you can't help but to like... When you really want to get out of that shit, but you don't like... You know, it's easy to like go and like... You know, you look up like these people that are already doing their own shit. You get stuck in that hole.
It's a lack of motivation.
Yeah. But there's this one dude... And I forgot his name and shit, but he said that it was like, you got to enjoy the process of it. You got to embrace the process because that's what's going to get you to where you are. So if you have the end result like in your head all the time and you compare that vision of what you have as the end result of where you want to be and you keep comparing that to what you are right now.
Yeah.
Obviously, it's going to be like shitty in your eyes.
Yeah, it's going to be different.
Yeah.
Because you can't be a pro, like, you know, right off the bat with anything. With anything,
yeah.
You know?
I mean, and that's obvious. Yeah. But, like, a lot of people don't think, like, damn, like, you're right. Like, if I embrace, like, if I, like, engulf myself in the fucking, like, process, like, then you'll go further like that, I guess. I don't know how to really explain that.
Yeah,
but.
And you just got to enjoy doing it because, like, you're going to learn a bunch of stuff when you do stuff like that.
Yeah, I agree.
And
with
you
that.
Might even find different interests, bro. Like mine.
True.
Mine went from football, the dream of becoming an NFL football player, to doing film.
Dude,
which is like just two completely different mediums.
And hell, I thought I was going to do graphic design.
Yeah.
And I actually went to school.
Are you still going to do that?
Here's the thing, bro. I went to school and I realized that shit is more like of a like. It's not an office job, but it's professional.
Yeah.
Like, you got to have clients and all this shit. Me, personally, I want to be free with what I'm creating, bro. Mm-hmm. I don't want to create shit for clients. It's in like, I'm going to just be real. I don't want to fucking limit myself to, like, what clients are asking me to do.
So, you just want to make your own graphic designs? Maybe people buy them?
Yeah, I just want to do my own shit. Oh, so you want to
be like an artist, kind of?
I want to be an artist.
You still can.
Obviously. And I'm going for that shit. You know, yeah. I'm in trade, but it's because, like, I want to have, you know, the economic stability to be able to get to where I want to be, you know, art-wise. You know, because I want to have that freedom. It's just my way of doing things.
That's,
you know,
a good thing, like, that you're doing that, because, like, a lot of people, they just choose economic stability over these other things, that, like, their dreams, I would say. It's corny, but I really do believe you should follow your dreams, dog. And, like, I understand, like, you should strive to stay, you know, like, good with money and all that kind of stuff.
It's because, look, here's the thing, bro. Here's my view on it, bro. Here's my view on it. I'm not someone that, I mean, granted, what the fuck is
Oh,
that?
Wow.
Is that on it?
That's Maddie. Okay, you're good. It's not recording that.
All right, but so I don't know. I think my thing is, like, my what drives me to do the art and shit is more like personal. You feel me? Like a personal interest.
Yeah.
It's not like struggle wise. Like, you know, like, you know, you see all these artists come up from fucking nothing.
Yeah.
But it's because they put their all into art. Mm. I don't feel that I'm pushed to that extreme. You know? So when I mean economic stability, it's like, come on, like, I wanna have my own little, like, at least like a little apartment and shit, so I can have my own space and be in my own household. Yeah, bro. I wanna have my own fucking space, bro. Like, I wanna have people, like, peeping in my door and shit, like, you know, living with family and all that shit. Like, I don't wanna do that. I wanna have my space for me to focus on what I'm gonna do.
You're saying you don't wanna live with Yaya?
No, fuck that shit, bro.
Not Yaya's his grandma.
Yeah, bro,
she's awesome.
I mean, yeah, but, like, bro, you just can't be loud past 12 p.m., bro, because then she thinks she entered heaven, and then she start, like, fucking, like, banging on that, like, fucking wall and shit, and I'm like, yo, yeah, it's just me, you feel me? Like, it's all right. Like,
I was tweaking, bro.
She's tweaking, bro. start hearing, like, the trumpets of heaven and all that shit, bro.
No, I agree with you.
Yeah, and also, like, I'm wild, bro. And, like, my family, like, that I'm living with right now, they're not about, like,
No, you're good. Keep it.
All right, but they're not about, like, they don't have the same energy as me, bro. Like, I want to, like, I don't want to have boundaries, bro. Like, I want to draw on the walls and shit. Like, I want to grab, like, a spray can and just, like, be able to, like, shit, you know? Like,
no, I think it's very important to have your independence.
Exactly.
Because that's a very important thing to, you know, to have when going for whatever you want to do, because, like, that's your journey. Exactly. And you don't want to be bound by other people and all that kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying? So but I mean, what, you don't want her there? Well, I mean, she'll draw on the walls with you.
No. Nah, man,
why not?
She'll
tell us about Yaya.
Dude, she too religious for all that shit, bro. Hell nah, bro.
I don't know if we should get into that.
She'll, like, start hanging rosaries up and all that shit on my, like, there's nothing wrong with religion.
There's no wrong with
that. But she old, bro. She don't know the concept of, like, graffiti.
Like, kind of like the,
she don't know what that is.
The progressive nature of our society.
Exactly. Or she don't, like, bro, she watches fucking YouTube church.
Dude, respect.
I mean,
Yaya's grinding. She's her journey.
She grinding, bro.
Y'all don't even know. Yaya is grinding.
Yo,
her religion. I if you think about it like that, she is.
I mean, yeah, bro. She stayed true to that shit. I won't even lie.
I respect that. I respect
look up to that shit. Hell yeah, staying true to your fucking passion.
Stay true, Yaya. Shout out to Yaya if you're listening to this.
She's not.
She won't. She won't. She
maybe probably it'll come up on her recommendation. You know.
Like, oh my God, Juan.
Oh shit. Puts her glasses on and shit.
You put your glasses on. Your HVAC glasses. Fucking
banging on my door.
Run,
like,
run.
Oh, he looks like you. He looks like you. Like, bitch, that is me.
Calling your grandma a bitch, huh?
Yo, I mean, I fuck with her a lot. She likes it. She thinks it's funny too.
Oh, what? Do you actually? You say shit like that to her?
Yeah.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I do. I do crazy shit to Yaya.
Okay, but
bro,
she probably doesn't understand. Okay.
Yeah. I won't lie. She, like, kind of doesn't understand, but she knows.
Hey,
like,
grandma, you bitch.
What? I mean, no. Like, like fucking with her and shit.
Oh,
like
just messing around with her.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I got you. Oh, I do that too. I do that with my grandma. Yeah. I love my grandma. Shout out to my grandma. Shout out to G-Ma. That's anyways, what I call my grandma. Enough about your grandma.
Grandmas and shit like
that's
that.
That's what the title is going to be.
Grandma.
Juan's talk. Grandma. Not Yaya. My fucking featuring grandma. Yaya. You think she'd come on the podcast?
Fuck no.
Why not?
Dude, nah.
I'll talk about religion with her.
I mean, I guess.
I probably won't understand her. Because yo, I'm terrible at Spanish.
At least one picture of the Virgin Mary up in this bitch for her to step in here.
I'd take everything out.
But yo, let's talk about your room, bro.
What about it? They can't see my room, but what about it?
How's the privacy in here?
Privacy. It's good. I don't know
why I fucking asked that question, but I mean, I guess.
It's good. The privacy's good. I mean, my sister moved out.
She's in the next room.
Yeah, she was in the next room, so it's like I just kind of have this side of myself. My aunt lives there now, though, for the moment.
Oh
yeah, she's staying with us because she got a job down here. And she had to come down here, like, ASAP. But she's going to stay down here for a bit until she can find a good place, and then she's gonna move in there. But
where was she staying at prior to that?
Connecticut. That's where my whole family's like based at.
Damn, what the fuck?
Yeah, we're from up north. It's pretty cool. But no, my room. Funny thing is that actually, like, I think my sophomore year, dude, I had nothing in here because we had just moved. I think like the spring, my freshman spring break, or around that time, and I had like nothing in here. Like, literally, I had a desk. So, my bed was always there, but I had a desk right there.
Over there.
No, right, just right here under my whiteboard, but I never even had a whiteboard. It was just my desk and a lava lamp, and that was all. And that's all I had. Crazy. And the walls were blank. But, yeah, then I decided to put pictures
up. Oh, wait,
up.
Yeah, because Jeremy was sitting there when he was doing the guitar.
Yeah,
said
he didn't have much there, yeah. But now I found a liking to, like, art. I very like local artists and stuff like that, I guess, like
respect.
I just like independent artists, I guess, is what you what to say. And I've been trying to get a lot of that, dude. I have a bunch though. I have like this J. Cole one that I like won off Twitter. I was taking a shit and I forgot. Yeah, okay, so like
you want some J. Cole off shit
while I was shitting? Yeah, dude, I took a shit and then I was taking a shit. And, like, 2 weeks before, I had, like, tweeted at the dude. He was just, like, tweet at me if you want to win this giveaway. I just tweeted at him, and I was shitting, and then I was like, oh, my God, I won this. And I got it in the mail, like, a week later. It's actually really cool.
What is it at?
It's way up there. I'll show it to you after. But then I also have this, like, Childish Gambino one. Then I just got this other one from San Francisco. It's, like, from the shop. That's where we got yours.
That was sick.
It has a bunch that of was sick. Yeah, it has yeah, a bunch
actually,
of local artists.
I'm going to go get it. I'm going to show it to the camera.
I can just put a picture up.
You're right.
Yeah, that's. I might put some pictures up.
It's like, pretty fucking sick, though.
Yeah, no, I'm gonna put that was a really cool poster.
When I get home, for sure.
Yeah, I want to put mine up. I got one of Martin Luther King, Nelson Mandela, Malcolm X, and Obama.
Respect.
And why? I feel like some people are going to ask me why I got this. Like, oh, well, you're not African-American. But
it doesn't fucking matter, though.
I don't know. I have a feeling that someone's going to say something like that. So what I will say is that what I like, especially Nelson Mandela, is that Nelson Mandela, basically, I don't know if you like know the whole thing, but basically he was thrown in jail or whatever, and like after the apartheid or whatever, he got out. Apartheid was like, you know what that is, right?
The Mandela effect story.
That's not what happened. Anyway, basically he like took the time to sit down and understand the quote unquote enemy, I guess, if you want to say, and he took time to understand them and try to mend the relationship of his people with them after, you know, he was thrown in jail for like 20 years or however long it was, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, his people were did wrong, and he took the time to understand them and he mended a country. So I respect him very much. And you know, all the other people, you know, Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, and even Obama, like, they fought for, you know, something they truly believed in, you know.
It's inspiring.
Yeah. It's inspiring. So that's why I got it. But oh my god, I thought my dog came in. Anyway, that's why I got it.
Me too.
And yeah, no, that shop was really cool.
It's pretty fucking dope.
Yeah,
San Francisco.
Yeah, that's cool.
What's the shop name?
I don't know.
Link in the description below.
Link in the description. don't blow the mic out.
I won't.
But yeah, no, it's cool. But
that's pretty fucking sick, though.
Anything you want to say? Closing remarks?
Closing remarks. I'm glad we're doing this, bro.
Yeah.
Episode one, Episode one. Bedroom podcast.
Episode one. I'll definitely have one again.
For sure.
I'll definitely
I'll be reoccurring on here.
I'll have one again on there. I don't know who's going to be next episode, but someone will be. And hopefully it'll be next week. I'll put his social media in the description. I'll put his stuff.
Socials in the description.
Yeah, I'll put his stuff in the description. Hopefully I'll have a new episode next week. Thank you for watching. If you made it this far,
appreciate you.
Yeah, appreciate you. Hopefully this goes well. I'm going to try to do this as often. Either way, I'm just going to keep doing it. I have a lot of time this summer. I bought this stuff. Like $300. But, no, I mean, it was worth it. So I'm going to keep doing them. I will see you guys hopefully next week. I hope.
Or after.
Yeah. What's today? Thursday? Wednesday? It's Wednesday. I'm going to try to post this.
Don't even set a date.
I'm not going to set a date, but I'm going to try to post this. So, yep. Thank you for watching. I appreciate you. Peace.
Peace.